prayers spoken us in our hearts, we place an infinite prayer trusting your will through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated now with the presentation of the gifts. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of Karl, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son, the beloved Savior, may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere giving thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in him the hope of the resurrection has gone, though saddened by the uncertainty of time, I'm consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not end. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing of your glory.
Oh,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and of all the creatures rightly give you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and work of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things, and you make them holy. You never cease to gather our people yourself, so the rising of the sun to the setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered in your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you, may the same Spirit grace make holy these gifts we have brought to you in consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night of betrayal, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, be poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The mystery of faith.
Thrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for the faith of God. May the sacrifice of reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis our Pope, John our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember Karl, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with his Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth, he will raise up the flesh of those who died and transform our lowly bodies after a pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed sisters and brothers too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give them kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when every tear will be wiped away from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, to Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom is known the world, all that is good.
Through him and with
Christian faith gathered here to honor Karl, let's turn to the Father and to pray in one voice.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Grant us peace in our days, that by the help of mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait for blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on the sins of an invading church, and grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. And maybe for a moment, just pray for that gift of peace, particularly in the troubled parts of our world these days. And as a sign of our solidarity, we're always working towards peace. Let's turn those around us and offer that sign of peace to each other. Thank you.
Oh.